الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا. أما بعد، يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except on a state of Islam. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, will bestow upon us the great gift to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling upon the believer with one of the greatest way to honor his servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا. This command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes from the Lord of the world that he started with himself. He said, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conferred his salat on his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his angels are also invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for such dua and supplication for the favor of the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore, all you who believe, do such for your prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the salah, it is in it, as you see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to choose the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be truly the best of the creation. The best of creation in his worship, the best of the creation in his servitude to Allah, the best of the creation in his conduct, the best of the creation in his behavior, the best of the creation of to be hamidan lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, celebrating the praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the salat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is indeed an increase of barakah and blessing to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because indeed the meaning of the salat of Allah on his Prophet and on the believers is the increase of the barakah. The same for the believers. And when you think of it, is the salat that it will strengthen and raise high and give more a greater position, a lofty position to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his aliyin, and to many great more reverence to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now when we think about the salat, and that's one of his great wisdom, that the salat of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as by nature the meaning of the salat increased the blessing, which is mean it increased the blessing in spreading the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, increased the blessing within the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is mean the continuation of the salat equal the continuation of the message to the end of the time. And the believer, when he's doing the salat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's actually benefiting himself and herself by trying by the salat to really invite more blessing into the light that they are adhering to the light that they are embracing of the guidance, and therefore they will be strengthening their position toward the iman and with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help them better. Therefore the salat, when he said, Ya Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is indeed you are honoring yourself, you are assisting your iman, you are enhancing your position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by calling more barakah into your way. Because the barakah that you ask him for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to be reflecting on you. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor the believers when they say, one time sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confer on them blessing 10 times. As in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala man salla alayya marrah sallallahu alayhi ashra, whoever who offered the salat on me one time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do it for him 10 times. And imagine all these blessings. So the blessing of the salah, it's like subhanallah, embracing or encompassing the whole guidance of Islam, to have it like subhanAllah, nourish it with more barakah, and this barakah comes with the salat of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to know the greatness and the position of your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, when you know such a thing, you know that anyone who want to diminish in his mind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that it will not happen at all. Because whatever bigotry, whatever mocking, whatever thing that been said about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not touch his holiness, does not reduce a bit from his greatness or from his nobility, subhanallah. He is already, subhanallah, in a place, lofty place, in near of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala fi maq'adi sidqin 'inda malikin muqtadir. However, when you think about it, the situation, especially that what you hear and what you have heard and learned and reading in the news and so on, when you reflect on it, subhanAllah, that's first the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put it on the side, that's nothing will touch the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'll give you the evidence. The first evidence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, inna Allah qala sayakfika al-mustahzeen. Allah will suffice you, all the mockers or those who making the scoff. So, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in Surah Al-Hijr. قَالْ فَصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ. Declare what you have been, you know, commanded to declare. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffice with these people. And in Surah Al-Ma'idah, قَالَ يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلَّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ. Focus, Ya Rasulullah, in conveying the message of the truth, the message of the mercy, the message of the truth, the ultimate truth, to the whole humankind. And if you don't do so, then you didn't do your task. Wallahu ya'simuka minan nas. Know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you. Protect you from anything. Protect you from the people. And here, subhanAllah, when you think about anything that been written or the thing that been, subhanAllah, drawn, nothing have to do with the Prophet. We have to think such a thing. Nothing have to do with the Prophet. So we see like anything, like the caricature or things, nothing have to do with the Prophet. The Prophet, it does look, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Amr ibn al-As, he said, I could not even, for the time being with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I could not fill my eye with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because by respect, by veneration to him, I could not. And he said, if you ask me to describe for you the Prophet, I would not be able to, because I could not at any time satisfy and fill my eye by looking to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this, Ikhwani, your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, the hadith of the Prophet, he said to his companion, قَالَ أَلَا تَعْجَبُونَ. Don't you be amazed how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is turning back from me the insult of Quraysh? They said, how, Ya Rasulullah? قَالَ, they call me مُذَمَّمَة. They say مُذَمَّمَة, the disgraced one, the disgraced one. Did they insult مُذَمَّمَة? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them to change the name of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so to not touch him. قَالَ وَأَنَا مُحَمَّدًا. قَالَ يَسُبُّونَ وَيَشْتُمُونَ مُذَمَّمًا وَأَنَا مُحَمَّدٌ. My name is the praised one, not the disgraced one. And this is, subhanAllah, it's a way of understanding, to put yourself in that right position and not to be hurting in a way that you lose it. But yes, it does hurt, but in a way that you need to build for it the right action. And in the other topic, when you think about the image of the Prophet ﷺ, as Umar ibn al-As, who lived with him, he would not be able to describe it. Look at the sheaf of the deceiver, ash-shaytanu iblis, la'anahu Allah. He will be doing anything. He will put all his power, all his ability, all his cunning, maybe to take the form or the image of the Prophet ﷺ just to distract or to delude people. And the Prophet ﷺ said that he was not able. It's impossible for him to take the form of the Prophet ﷺ, even in the dream. The Prophet said in a hadith, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man ra'ani fil manami faqad ra'ani haqqa. Whoever who see me in sleep, he truly saw me. Because the shaitan is impossible for him to take my form. So, you see, dear brother, respected sister, that's a fact, that's a reality. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the trustworthy. Suddenly he became like, you know, the sorcerer, the poet, the charlatan, and so on and so on. This is the nature of the aqidah. Therefore, what you are seeing, it is, subhanAllah, fabricated, either images or saying as an expression of hatred to this deen, as an expression for people who are, you know, accusing Muslim to be terrorist or divider, as actually an expression of causing all the enmity, of causing the hatred, of causing the discrimination, of causing the rejection. There is no such a thing. If it's done, you seek and you say, this is the alignment, this is the peaceful coexistence of people. There is no such a thing can be achieved by that. And when you talk to yourself and you say freedom of speech, this is hypocrisy. It's not freedom of speech. And it's so obvious. We will not be talking about it, and we don't want to talk about it because it's so obvious. They have two measures. So when you say the true freedom is the freedom when it comes from the heart of the noble people, is to change things, to establish justice, to restore peace, not to cause hurt and hurting. That's not speech. That's not freedom at all. And here, dear brother, respected sister, one of us need to say, when you hear such a thing, what you should do is an action of iman, is an obligation to stand against it. But however, how to stand against, is that the question? But there is no question or doubt that you have to stand against it. And standing against it comes from two evidence from the Sharia. The first evidence is like you are required by the iman to love the Prophet ﷺ more than you do love yourself. And this is, as we'll explain it, is not something that you're going to strive to have it. If you are a true believer, it comes automatically. And then the second one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told you, and the evidence, I will mention it, you will have time later. But the second evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we have sent the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a witness, as a bearer or of glad tidings, as a warner. إِنَّ أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولُهُ, for you to believe in Allah and His Messenger. قَالَ وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ وَتُوَقِّرُوهُ, and to help him, to honor him, and to assist him. So as a believer, is part of your iman. And how come someone, for example, if you love truly your child, and anyone who will do anything for your child, how you react? If you truly love your parents, if someone will hurt your parents, or tell you something, or slander, or mock your parents, how will you react? And this is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we love him more than we love ourselves, more than we love our children, more than we love our parents. And this is, subhanAllah, what is as a requirement of iman. However, how are you going to react? There is many things. As long as that is the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially with no violence, because the Prophet, that's not his way sallallahu alaihi wasallam at all. At all. And whoever who does such a thing, he's not following the legacy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How then he claimed the love of the Prophet when he's not doing and following his path? Now, the biggest question, how can we honor the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and assist the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in such a thing? Because this is for us, as we have said, it does not touch the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at all. But this is a trial for us, a trial for our identity, trial for our faith. Because without the love, if they take away the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by shaking it into our heart and then have us to be like neglectful, you know, forget about them, this is going to cause an erase, suppressing the identity of belief. Why? Because the true belief started from that love of Allah and His Messenger. If you take that part of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then what's remained from the belief? However, how can we do that? What is in order of precedence, what is the highest action that we need to do? There's many things that are like lawful, you know, but we say for you, as if this is a trial for you, this is not for the Prophet, it does not touch the Prophet. What you have seen, nothing have to do with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it's hurting us. You as a believer, in this blessed month in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born, and in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was migrated to Medina, and in the same time also month that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. So in this blessed month, and this trial of your iman, how should you make the true assisting, helping and supporting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The answer is simple, is to behave like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is, I will tell you a story, a true story that happened in Europe actually. Someone who is a Jew, who really Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened his heart to Islam. He was looking and reading, And he grabbed a book about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He read the book, he loved this book. And then when he first time he entered the masjid to see the implementation, the incarnation of this great moral of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the masjid, he didn't see it. He left. And after a while he came back because he's reading something very attractive. He met one, an eloquent da'iyah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him more reward. And he told him, look, I have been reading, but I think that the author of this book is a liar. He told him, what a book? He said, this book about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the author is a liar. He told him, why are you saying that? He said, because I want to the people who say the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I saw them, you know, doing the opposite of this book. So it's either the book is lying or these people are not the follower of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, indeed, they are, but they do not act. And that book is the truth. And this person came to Islam. Therefore, saying subhanallah is us who need to start by this trial to know better your Prophet, to know better or to implement the way how to change yourself. How can we do? We're not going to tell you, look, if you want to be like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have to implement the whole Quran, because the Quran was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the Quran walking. But we're saying, how can we do such a thing? Wallahi, it's easy. It's easy. Because you find the essence of the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his servitude to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complimented him by saying servant to Allah. So therefore he say, if I'm follower of the Prophet, I need to be servant to Allah. If you look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his servitude, where he, you find it that is being performed into the best of its way, is in the salah, isn't salah. You remember in the khutbah we said, when you enter your grave, it's like you enter your salah. This is how you're going to connect it. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, the delight of my eye is in the prayer, which he find like, subhanAllah, the greatest happiness, the joy of the soul, the expansion of the breast, the peace of the mind, all what you can say it from, the describe it as the sweetness in the being, the Prophet ﷺ find it in the salah when he's standing, seeing and looking at Allah with the eye of his heart. This is, subhanAllah, what happened when you do such a thing. It arose from it a flood of sakina, of tranquility, make you a person that is kind of merciful like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Therefore, if you want to be and grab and have to incarnate that identity, true, sound, authentic identity as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had it, is within his ubudiyya, let's start with the salah. Let's start with the salah by changing you, so it changes your character, it changes your behavior, and the behavior that you change it, and you'll be kind and merciful in the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which means in the way that you love in the sake of Allah and you dislike in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Akhwani, there's a lot of things to say about that, but just if you take this point, because we cannot be follower of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when we are neglecting our ubudiyyah. When we are neglecting our identity, we cannot be follower of the Prophet ﷺ by taking the name of Islam and use it to serve an agenda. It's an agenda in any field. Because when you say, I am a follower of the Prophet ﷺ, you say, I am a servant of Allah. I am a servant of Allah, it means I have an identity that been defined by Allah and His Messenger. That I have a way of character and behavior that is being already taught by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's the way how can you honor the Prophet and assist the Prophet and support the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you truly Allah saying with from your heart, Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Rasulillah, you have to do it from its root, from its essence, started from the salah, in the way that you make your salah is to be the change of your behavior, of your character and your life. If you want to have an idea about how great he was sallallahu alaihi wasallam, maybe by reading, you know, all these great actions that he did, some of that might not be able to taste it, but to just look as his companion. When he entered the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on his companion, nobody looked at him out of respect. There's the two, Anas ibn Malik, there's only two they can look, they lift their head to look at him, is Abu Bakr wa Umar. He said, he smiled to them and they smiled to him back. When he talked to them, as he said in the narration, it's like, subhanAllah, you see them in full devotion. It's like birds are, as subhanAllah, are on their head. Birds standing on their head, so they do not move. They do not. When the Prophet ﷺ goes to a barber shop, and you said like all his companions around him, there is no one hair that it falls, but it falls in the hand of his companion. This is the love that they have to their Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the love. After him, Al-Imam Malik, when they mentioned the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his first face turned pale. And he inclined down, and then they told him, tell to the people around him, they don't know how to sit, they don't know how the position to take with him. Then they asked him, said, yeah, Imam, I mean, we saw you every time the name of the Prophet ﷺ is mentioned, you do such a thing. He said, if you see what they have seen, you will deny such a thing, you will belittle it. He said, I will have seen Sayyidul Qurra Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir, the best of the Qurra. From our shuyukh, Muhammad ibn al-Munkadir, when we ask him about hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he starts to cry, say, subhanAllah, till we have mercy on him. We leave, and he's still crying. And he said, one of my shuyukh, I went to him two times for hajj. I see him, and I listen to him, and he does not speak. But when the name of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned, he falls in tears. And definitely, he said, wallahi, hatta narhamu. And this is Amir al-Mu'mineen Abu Ja'far. He was in a discussion with Al-Imam Malik fi al-Madina. And he told him, when he started to speak, he told him, oh, your voice, do not raise your voice above the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is venerated as life, as dead. And this is, dear brother, respected sister, the way that our Salaf, they have venerated, they have respected. And the respect of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is going to cleanse the pot, which is your heart, that container. Because if you want pour into taqwa, you have to have it prepared. How can you prepare it? The preparation of this container to have the taqwa get into it is the love of the Prophet. إن الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم للتقوى. And this is what Imam Malik said to Al-Khalifa. He told him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have corrected people by when they raising their voice. And he complimented people because they are controlling and putting down their voice. And that's out of iman. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala imtahana. You know what is imtahana? He had ready. He cleansed their heart. He prepared it to be, subhanallah, inviting and having be ready to have taqwa inside it. When our heart has a lot of whims, you cannot put taqwa. So you say, how can I prepare my heart for that taqwa to get in? For the amal, for the good action to be sweet. For the me to be racing for the good. He said, you have to cleanse it. How? By the respect of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who venerate and respect the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow upon us the action in our heart of His love more than we do for ourselves. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. It is a question of iman, as we have said, and is a question of a trial for us, and a trial that it really, you know, try our identity, try our belief, and if we believer, the first action that all of us we are requested to do is to stand against such a thing by reviewing your position toward the Prophet ﷺ. Do you truly love the Prophet? It is difficult for our generations today to answer this question. Because with individualism that we live in, how can someone love the Prophet more than he loves himself? But there is a way. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not burden you more than you can bear. It is in Surah At-Tawbah, it is an obligation to love the Prophet and to love Allah first and the Prophet, and striving in His sake more than you do for yourself, or for you seeking for your parents, or for your children, or for your spouses, or for your business, or for your anything else. There's two type of love. The love that comes from the heart, which is the love, you know, with the feeling. And there's the love that you call it the imani love, the love within the faith. The love within the faith is more reasoning love. Through reasoning, you love the Prophet ﷺ. As Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, I love you, Rasulullah, more than anything else except myself. He told him, no, ya Umar. Umar took a time and he said, I love you more than I love myself. And the question is, how Umar, in few minutes or 1 minute, he changed his heart? No, this is what helped us to understand. Umar was saying, as I'm going to share with you, he said, the Prophet ﷺ care about you more than you care about yourself. The Prophet ﷺ love you more than you love yourself. Therefore, loving the Prophet by reason, by way of reasoning, by logic, that he will be better for you than your own self. That's why loving the Prophet more than you love yourself is honoring yourself. It's not adding any great to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is, here comes the requirement of the iman. Then when you think about the salat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, within this perspective, you know that every salat that you do on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you're increasing yourself in the rank of his love in this way. So it helps to honor yourself more. And I finish with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As. He said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reading ayah from Surah Ibrahim, and Ibrahim was talking about the idol. He said, ya Allah, they misled and they led astray many of the people. Ya Allah, whoever who follow me, you are, he's one of me, and whoever who does not follow me and disobey me, you are the oft forgiven, the most merciful. And then he read from the ayah from Surah Al-Ma'idah. In the end of Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa, he said, ya Allah, if you forgive them, if you do forgive them, they are your servant. And if you punish them, you are the Almighty, the All-Wise. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, thinking about that, thinking about some of his ummah, they will not be with him. Some of this ummah they will be against. Some of this ummah they will be saying ill talk to him. So, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cried very hard for you. And he said, ya Rabbi ummati, ummati. He said, my ummah, ya Allah, my ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel, and he already know. He told him, ask Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam why he's crying, why he's weeping. And Jibreel came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, ya Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent me to you, and Allah already know. He said, why you are weeping? He said, ya Jibreel, ummati, ummati. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to Jibreel to inspire him, tell him, tell to Muhammad, sanurdhika fi ummatika wa la nasu'uk. We're going to please you into your ummah, and we're not going to displease you. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in reading the ayah in Surah Al-Duha, في قوله سبحانه وتعالى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى, and Allah will give you till you get pleased, he said, this is the best ayah for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will not please it till all of you enter the Jannah. However, today you know your Prophet, you know how keen and how sallallahu alaihi wasallam want you to be with him. Do you want to be with him? And if there's one invitation for all of us today, is the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. Let help our Prophet. Let help our Prophet to have his dua accepted for us with multiplying the sujood. As he said to one of his companions, he said, do you have anything you want to ask? He said, ya Rasulullah, I want to be with you in the Jannah. He said, then help me with your request by more sujood. Let's help our Prophet ﷺ by honoring yourself, by adding the more sujood. And the more sujood means the servitude. The servitude means the identity. Therefore, if you go against the identity, if you go against the ubudiyyah, if you go against and reducing your sujood, you'll not be able to be candidate to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dua, as you have said. فمي الله سبحانه وتعالى make us خاشعين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from عباده المتقين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cleanse our heart to be the right recipient for the taqwa. يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ربنا آتي نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. اللهم ارزقنا حب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.